Hey, what's going on, my friends? I'm back with another video, and today it's a bit of an unplanned video, admittedly, so I might be rambling along for some minutes, but I just wanted to give you an update about the channel here and talk about some of the things that popped up over the last weeks. Now, first of all, I won't be able to upload as many videos as I'm usually doing over the next 2-3 weeks. Simply because my mom is here, and instead of sitting in front of the computer and editing videos, I just want to spend some quality time with her. Don't take it personal, I still love you guys, but you know, mom goes first. Now, one of the things that I really wanted to talk about is the Sony RX100 Mark VI, a camera that I was really hoping to buy as a good companion to my main camera, the Sony A6500, which is currently shooting this video. It makes mix and matching footage much easier. And as you know, at least for the ones who follow my video, my current point and shoot camera, the Panasonic LX10, gave me some grief and issues, so I was really hoping to replace it once the Sony RX100 Mark VI becomes available. Now, with the Sony RX100 Mark VI, I was hoping for some really big improvements, and in some areas we got them, in others I feel it's a bit of a letdown. Especially if you're a person like me who want to use this camera as a secondary video camera, for shooting B-roll or for vlogging, the things that we got, in my opinion, aren't really, you know, geared towards videographers, and it's probably more for photographers. But let's talk about this in a little bit more detail. Now let's start with the big selling point, and that is the 24 to 200 millimeter f/2.8 to 4.5 zoom lens. And it is absolutely insane how Sony managed to get such a huge range of a lens into a tiny body like the one of the Sony RX100 Mark VI. Otherwise, the RX100 Mark VI features a 1-inch 20.1 megapixel XMOR RS BSI sensor, a Bionz X Advanced Image Processing Engine, which allows for goodies like that super fast hybrid autofocus with 315 face detection points, the Sony A9 inherited eye autofocus and face detection algorithms, which will be awesome for vloggers, an unbelievable 24 frames continuous shooting with autofocus and auto exposure tracking, a 4K HDR video mode that will allow us to capture more details in very bright and dark parts of the image, which is super beneficial for extreme lighting conditions, and then something that I always enjoy using, which is super slow motion at up to 1000 frames per second. Additionally, we have a newly designed EVF that I personally wouldn't be using as much, but great for photographers. And then finally, what a lot of people have been asking for, and that is a display with touch capabilities. So now we have touch to focus, and then the capability of taking a photo by just touching the display, which is called touch shutter. Now with that, what is it that we are missing? Now first of all, the fast aperture. The Sony RX100 Mark V had an aperture of 1.8 to 2.8, which was great, especially for shooting in low light conditions and for getting that very shallow depth of field. The Sony RX100 Mark VI has an aperture of 2.8 to 4.5 as a trade-off for that longer lens, but I really have to say it's easy to compensate when shooting photos, when you're shooting video and you want to keep your ISO as an acceptable level. I'd rather have the aperture of 1.8 than that longer lens. What else is missing is the built-in ND filter. The Sony RX100 Mark V had a built-in ND filter, which is great for shooting video in bright daylight. If you want to still get that shallow depth of field, the Sony RX100 Mark VI doesn't have that anymore. Another huge drawback, especially if you're shooting video. Now, another thing that I was really hoping for is a microphone input. Nothing that Sony dropped, but if you want to market towards the video and vlogger community, and if you want to make people to choose a point and shoot camera over the smartphone that they already have in their pocket, you need to make it easy and convenient for them to shoot video. Especially if you know your Sony RX100 Mark V was the go-to camera for the vlogger community, I'm really baffled that we don't have a microphone input with the Sony RX100 Mark VI. And another thing that I was really hoping for that we didn't get, which is exactly the opposite of what we did get, is a wider lens. Remember the Nikon DL series that never made it to market? They had actually two different versions. They had an 18 to 50 and they had a 24 to 85. Which in my opinion was great. So the 24 to 85 was probably the go-to version for most people, but if you're a videographer and if you're a vlogger, 18 to 50 is the ideal lens to have as a point and shoot camera in your pocket. It would be awesome if Sony would take a similar direction to have two different versions, one RX100 that is more geared towards videographers and vloggers with a wider lens and a microphone input, and an ND filter, and another one that is probably more geared towards photographers, which what they currently already have. So Sony, if you hear me, please do that. I think it would be perfect for a lot of people. Go with two different versions and everyone is happy. So I was really hoping for a new point and shoot camera, especially one that gives me all the bells and whistles for shooting video and as a vlogging camera. Unfortunately, we didn't get it this time, so I have to stick to this little guy for longer, even though it gives me gray hairs every once in a while. But for $500, quite frankly, it gives you quite a lot. And in my opinion, $500-$600 is really as much as you want to really pay for a point and shoot camera like this. But let's see. Now, on a side note, if you have a look at my subscriber, actually, you should be subscribe now. Here, this subscribe. Now, okay. As a side note, as you can see, I'm soon to hit my 10,000 subscriber mark, which is huge. I'm super happy with the community that I'm building. So I want to give back and say thank you. So there will be the giveaway of the Firetek G6 gimbal. So if you don't want to miss it, subscribe now, hit that bell icon so you don't miss it and you can join. Now, before I close this video, I want to make sure to ask you what type of content you like on this channel. Lately, I've been shooting a lot of gear reviews and a lot of you guys enjoyed it. But if you're more into tutorials, if you're more into vlogs, if you want to, you know, learn more about how to use your camera or editing or color grading, just let me know so I can create content going forward that you guys really enjoy. So this is it, my friends. This is my update for today and I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. If you don't want to miss any of the new videos hitting this channel, and if you don't want to miss the giveaway that I'm currently working on, please subscribe and hit that bell icon. If you have any questions or feedback about any of the topics that I spoke about today, just leave a comment down below and I'll get back to you. And with that, as always, I'll catch you guys in my next video.